Welcome to part 4 of our battery desulfation series using the Epsom salt. Now, battery had time to do a full charge using a smart charger. Did get a little warmer than normal during the charge, but as you can see, same battery as yesterday. Let's do a little test, see exactly what we got. Now, the battery has been sitting. It's been about 4 hours since it's come off the charger, so the surface charge is pretty much dissipated. Remember, we're around 700 ohm resistance in the battery yesterday before doing anything to the battery at all. It was a full charge when the battery still had the dead cell. If you remember, we had added the Epsom salt mixture to each cell. Immediately it jumped up a bit. Now, this one had a dead cell. I believe that was cell number 2, this one right here. Right now, we're actually holding 12.67 volts. So it seems that dead cell is actually currently working. Now, battery's supposed to be 550 cranking amps. Battery has settled, though, at 120. Now, immediately off the charger, I was reading about 280 cold cranking amps. It has settled down to 120.5 at the moment, although that ohm reading is quite a bit lower than yesterday, so the resistance has gone down. I think we're at the limit to what the Epsom salt can do on its own at this time. So what I'm going to do for our last part of this specific series of videos, I do manufacture and build what's called capacitive battery chargers. Very simple devices. You can see our other YouTube videos for how to make your own. Use a capacitor, flip it around here, and a bridge rectifier to rectify your AC current into DC. Now these chargers can charge anything. They're any 12-volt any lead acid battery from 12 to about 130 volts off of a standard 110 power outlet. The reasoning behind that is when you rectify AC to DC, I'll give you an example, 120 volts AC gets rectified to 170-ish volts DC. So your DC voltage will always be higher. Now this is fully automatic voltage regulation, so the voltage will always go to the lowest needed in order to get the current to start flowing through the battery. So if you have a really sulfated battery, that, say, this battery was before we did any work on it yesterday, the voltage coming out of this thing can be pretty darn high. Doesn't mean the current is going to be any higher, it just means the voltage is going to be higher. And that's just to get the voltage starting to flow through the resistance. Now, another nice thing about these chargers is their desulfation properties. Now, our normal AC current runs at 60 Hertz in the U.S. here. Once rectified with our chargers, that 60 Hertz actually becomes 120 Hertz pulse. That pulsing, along with the, which is a sudden blast of voltage and current, helps desulfate sulfate crystals. And I guess that's really our goal of these videos that we're making here for you right now. So I have never tried pairing the Epsom salt. That was the first experiment I ever did, was our Alfa Romeo battery, which is charging over there. I'm seeing if I can get anything else out of it, which that really had not too much of a change. And this is the second battery, which seems to have been successful. I'll never use it in a car, because I don't feel like getting stranded somewhere, but for use in our forklift, or my riding lawnmower, might be just fine. So, got that hooked up. Going to go plug this in now. charger is plugged in. Now the battery in my multimeter here is actually starting to go. So it's not giving a correct reading for the in-battery voltage. I got to replace the 9-volt battery in here, then it'll give a correct reading. See, it's all over the place. But at least it tells us if there is a current flow or a voltage flowing into the battery. So we're going to turn that on there. You can watch that jump up. And that'll keep going. For some reason, these meters always read higher voltage when the battery's low in them. So if this says 14.5, it actually probably be about 14.2 volts. But what can you expect for a $1.99 Centec multimeter at Harbor Freight? I can't buy any voltage meter cheaper than that. So I'm gonna let that go. It's pulsating away. We're at to about 16 volts now. So I'm gonna let that pulse away. Timer's on. A little bit. Let's see. Shop's gonna be open here for another 3 hours today. So I'm gonna put it at 3 hours because I really don't want it running when no one's here, just in case I forget to unplug it before we leave. Yeah, we're about 16.5 volts, so it's voltage is really jumping up to break through that resistance in that battery. And you can tell that one cell that I think was dead is still heating up a little more than the other ones. But it's not hot. Warm's fine, hot's bad. Boiling and bubbling, it will boil and bubble a little bit with these chargers, but that's fine. And I'll see you in the next video with the results, which will probably be, we'll see if I might be able to get one done today, because we're closed now. It's Friday, we're closed until Monday this weekend. I'd rather not wait that long to keep my suspense. No cliffhangers here. I hate cliffhangers. So, we're at about 18.5 volts being put in the battery now. So, see you at the next video. And, if all goes well, we'll see what happens. Because then I still got a battery in the forklift that needs to be reconditioned. And I might even have a few motorcycle batteries that I'll be doing next, so catch you in the next segment, which will be the results of a capacitive battery charger. One last note, I do use the exact same style charger, only a different casing. I like the wood box in the shop here because it is very durable, but I do have a stainless steel box in my electric Alfa Romeo that I have 8 capacitors in, and it can charge a 1200 amp hour 132 volt battery pack in about 12 hours or less, depending on how much I discharge the batteries. Very efficient chargers, and they really help to extend the life of your batteries. So see you in a bit. Oh, and a last note, because I forgot to shut the video off. As you can see, the voltage is kind of peaking off there. As it starts to drop, it's still going up slightly. As that voltage starts to drop, that means it's starting to break through the sulfate, and the resistance of the battery is lowering. And then it'll reach its low point, and then at that point, once the voltage starts to slowly this time, not as fast jump up as fast as it did, now, but once the voltage starts to slowly go up, that's when the battery is actually nearing a full charge, or fully full charge of what it's currently capable at.